Places gifted and talented women and men in situations where they must make a choice. The choice she made was on the afternoon of the 1st of December, 1955, on a bus as she was going home from her seamstress job in a department store in Montgomery, Alabama.
Rosa, along with three other black passengers, were told to give up their seats to a white male passenger. She refused and was arrested. An all-day bus boycott was organized on the day of Rosa's trial, December 5th, 1955, where she was fined $14 and found guilty.
She was a role model for courage in the face of racial injustice. Rosa Parks, through her quiet eloquence, through her commitment both to her faith and to the cause of civil rights and racial equality, was prepared to sacrifice everything, her security, even her life, to fight for what was right, at least her perception of what was justice.
We have got in these hands our power, the people's power.
We are going to dismantle apartheid. With a
Sakamula apartheid.
We are not prepared for any so-called reforms to apartheid. You cannot reform a sin. Apartheid is a criminal act against mankind.
I still feel that the police on the beat don't get it. I would walk past. And I see one individual, a young black man. He probably had about six officers around him. Now, do you need that amount, that intimidation? Do you need that amount of officers? No, you don't. And the level of how they speak to young people. So young people don't have the respect that they should. And that's part of what comes as a recommendation, is the respect that officers expect to get from the public. But if you don't show that respect, how do you expect to get it back yourself?
I think that the dice are loaded, and that's what's left out of Mr. Brown's piece. Mm-hmm. See, there was a period of time in this country after Reconstruction where African people owned a lot of land, owned a lot of businesses, and did a lot of things. But what happened was the American government, the Ku Klux Klan, and other organizations organized in smashing that effort. So it's not that we haven't tried to own lands and have not organized businesses. It's that if you are African in America, or in Latin America, or in the Caribbean, or in the continent, you will be hunted no matter what you do, because they do not want us to survive and become self-sufficient. Well, and you can say no, but you haven't lived this life. You haven't lived it.
Buildings are burning is because this city, this state, would prefer preserving that white nationalism and that white supremacist mindset over arresting, charging, and helping to convict four officers who killed a black man. That is the reality of what we're dealing with. This is not just a few cops doing things across the country. This is not a good cop versus bad cop situation. This is Ahmaud Arbery being shot down by white men on the streets of Georgia. Breonna Taylor being killed in her home. This is in New York City, where we were until freedom. We were just in New York fighting the police officers who, in the name of social distancing, were damn near killing black young people on our streets. This is a coordinated activity happening across this nation. And so we are in a state of emergency. Black people are dying. in a state of emergency. We cannot look at this as an isolated incident. The reason why buildings are burning are not just for our brother George Floyd. They're burning down because people here in Minnesota are saying to people in New York, to people in California, to people in Memphis, to people all across this nation, enough is enough. Yes. And we are not responsible for the mental illness that has been inflicted upon our people by the American government, institutions, and those people who are in positions of power. I don't give a damn if they burn down Target. Because Target should be on the streets with us, calling for the justice that our people deserve.
Talk about it, Tamika.
Where was AutoZone at the time when Philando Castile was shot in a car, which is what they actually represent? Where were they? So if you are not coming to the people's defense, then don't challenge us when young people and other people who are frustrated and instigated by the people you pay. You are paying instigators to be among our people out there throwing rocks, breaking windows, and burning down buildings. And so young people are responding to that. They are enraged, and there's an easy way to stop it. Arrest the cops. Charge the cops. Charge all the cops. Not just some of them, not just here in Minneapolis. Charge them in every city across America where our people are being murdered. Charge them everywhere. That's the bottom line. Charge the cops. Do your job. Do what you say this country is supposed to be about, the land of the free for all. It has not been free for black people, and we are tired. Don't talk to us about looting. Y'all are the looters. America has looted black people. America looted the Native Americans when they first came here. So looting is what you do. We learned it from you. We learned violence from you. We learned violence from you. The violence was what we learned from you. So if you want us to do better, then damn it, you do better.
Yes, Tamika.